Thank you very much. So yes, I'm the head of Fleet and Waste Management at Coventry City Council, and like many job descriptions within the council, what we actually do is far greater than our title. So as well as looking after waste, so I deal with rubbish, I also manage or look after the council's whole fleet of vehicles, I also look after taxis, I also look after passenger transport, and so I today come with a slightly different take on things. I often find that when we come to occasions such as this, we are a little bit preaching to the converted, because we're generally talking to people who want to change, are interested in change, are looking for ways to be able to change. In my role, 20 years local government in waste services, I've generally spent the last two decades trying to persuade people at the lower level to do the right thing. So I do come at this from a slightly different view. And technology, look at this. So 20 years, I've not been around this long to remember these kind of things, but believe me, we have people who work within the authority who have probably been around long enough to remember this. But what I, in my 20 years of working, what I have seen is lots and lots of changes in the way that technology, legislation has changed the way that we deal with waste, with transport, with all the things that we do, and have helped to add to the way that people think about the waste that they produce, the energy that they produce, and generally things. A lot of things have been changed by legislation. There is legislation that has come and gone and not made the changes that we've done. Anybody who's got a waste background will remember the landfill allowance scheme that was going to save the planet. Gone, didn't work. A lot of changes also at a local authority, at a more local level, are led by the austerity, by the fact that local authorities no longer have, we have significant cuts in funding. Not only are we looking to make changes to the way that we deliver services to do the right thing for the planet, but we've also got a very sort of, you know, serious note around the fact that there isn't the amount of money that used to be around, and actually some of the changes can have a double whammy in that we can make changes that are positive, but also hopefully save a little bit of money. Lots of changes globally recently. I'm sure we've all heard of what's gone on in China, in that China, who was the greatest, most of the places that your waste went when it left was China, because not unsurprisingly, they also manufacture, so they need the materials. China have very nicely decided, beautiful China, they've closed their doors to accepting exported waste, which has created great challenges across the world as to how we're going to deal with waste as we move forward. The government has set a new waste strategy that outlines how we're going to move forward. I'm surprised we've got this far in the day without anybody mentioning Brexit, but I'm going to do so. There is a new bill, an environment bill that is out there that looks to make huge changes around producer responsibility and all those kind of things, but there's something a little bit more important going on at the moment that is probably going to mean that that's going to take a little bit of while to come through. But no doubt it will set new challenges in the way that we think about the waste that we produce as we move forward. Producer responsibility being key, deposit return schemes are coming back. Anybody in the room old enough to remember when you used to take your bottle back to the and get your 10p on your Corona bottle? Well, guess what, as most things are, that's coming back round. And all of these things are going to change the way that local authorities have to think about the waste that they produce and how they deal with it. So very quickly, who are we and what do we do?
Problems.
Well, I'm pressing next.
Okay, Paul. Paul at the back. He's on it.
Okay, so who are we and what do we do? So Coventry City Council is a large employer in the city, and we recognise that as a business, we are a large employer, and therefore we have to think about our impact on the city. In our services and waste services, we have 54 rounds out every day. We collect around about just under 120,000 tonnes of waste last year. Paul.
There we go. It's catching up.
through our recycling, food and garden waste residual, and we also provide commercial waste services, and I'll cover a little bit of that later. So a little bit of an opportunity, a little bit of a sales pitch on some of the services that we can provide to local businesses in the city and the surrounding areas. Don't want to bore you on our waste figures, but we... So I'll just keep talking. Okay, thank you. So, yeah, not to bore you in there, but in 2017, Coventry City Council moved away from a weekly collection of its waste to an alternate weekly collection. I don't know where you come from in the country, but I suspect most of you now have your frequency of waste has changed over the last few years. Quite a brave move in large cities. It's a very political issue, waste collection. And although those numbers there don't show you that as a city, we're not up there with the best performing authorities in the country, as a city, we're pretty good. From moving to alternate weekly collection, this comes a little bit back to what we're here to talk about today. We did that for two reasons. We did it because we wanted to improve recycling. Yes, we did. We also did it because there was quite a large potential saving involved in reducing the amount of the frequency of that. And in the first year of that, we actually reduced the total amount of waste that we collect by 6,500 tonnes. And that doesn't sound much, but when you think that an average weight of a bin is 14 kilograms, that equates to us collecting almost 500,000 less bins in the first full year than we did the year before. And that comes down a little bit to waste miles, which I'll cover in a moment, hopefully. In addition, Coventry is developing a regional facility, its own materials recycling facility, working in partnership with a number of neighbouring authorities, where we're looking to build a facility quite just down the road here that has the capacity to accept up to 175,000 tonnes of recyclable waste from ourselves and our regional partners. And what not only does this reduce those risks that I talked about earlier around the fact that it's now more difficult to have waste treated and more expensive, but also if you think that up until recently Coventry's waste was collected by those 54 vehicles that were out, was then taken to a bulking facility, bulked up and taken to London to be treated, because that was the closest facility that we could find to accept our waste. When we're talking today about carbon emissions and the effect that our local fleet has on the environment, having a local facility for local authorities reduces the environmental impact of having to take waste large distances for it to be dealt with. Even worse is if you then put it on a boat and take it to China. So we could argue that China have done us a favour. A few of the things that we're quite proud of in the city.
They're coming.
If we do have any local residents, I hope you are, or people that are in this city, that you are members of our Coventry Recycling Club. We also work alongside, some previous speakers have mentioned, we work alongside with the universities. As a large university city, I'm sure as you go around Coventry, if you get the chance, you will see high-rises popping up everywhere as the university grows across the city. One of our challenges that we have with that kind of transient population is how you persuade those people, or how you make sure those people understand their requirements. So the Your Rubbish app was developed alongside Coventry University, so we can make sure that both Coventry residents and students know exactly what they need to do. And we also work with a local homeless charity. Homelessness in Coventry is an issue as much as it is across anywhere else in the country. And they carry out one of our legislative services that we have to carry out, our bulky waste collections. They do that for us. And that enables them to fund not only their local charity that they run, but also provides a far greater service to the citizens. Okay, so the next one is just a little bit of a plug. So if there are local businesses, Sarah mentioned earlier around the audits that they can do to make sure that businesses are as green as possible. So we have our own commercial waste service in the council called Waste Solutions, and they also can offer a range of services and solutions to the public, to businesses, on how to reduce the costs and the environmental impact and make sure that they comply with the requirements around waste. So if anybody is interested or would like any further advice, there is a local service from there as well. So our fleet services, as I say, we recognise in Coventry that we as a large business have a responsibility around the material, around the vehicles that we do. And we're all here talking about how we can make our fleets greener. I'm really interested to see some of the information that is out there. So we operate internally around 360 vehicles, just carrying out the mandatory services that the council has to provide. A variety of vehicles that you've seen there. And currently in Coventry, 30% of our fleet, only 30% of our fleet, is what we would call electric or hybrid. I'm sure you'll hear a lot more later on, so I don't want to spoil it, around opportunities that have become are becoming available for both the council and through the council in supporting local businesses to be able to green their fleets and take advantage of the opportunities to become more sustainable. And as I say, I'm sure you'll hear more about that later. So, as local authorities, climate change was touched on just a little bit there, and as local authorities, I think we need to recognise the importance that we can have. I've mentioned before how we're as businesses and moving forward into the country, but we do this at a very local level. So we are trying to persuade people on the bottom line, our residents, our people, to do the right thing. And I think understanding the role that local government has and you guys can have in those baby steps that we need to be able to make the changes. I think it's easy to sit back and say that issues like climate change, plastic pollution in the oceans at a local level, it doesn't affect us, somebody else will do it. But actually the power that we see as a local authority when nationally, suddenly plastic is the worst thing that anybody had ever invented. We could try all day at the local authority, but nationally, through businesses as well, actually getting that message out is far more effective. By going out and raising the awareness around climate change, we get residents coming to us and asking us what we're doing about it, and that's really, really important. So if they will let me, I will probably spend the next 20 years trying to persuade people to do the right thing, hopefully with the support of all of you in the room, because I think we all need to understand the importance of that.